Yes, good morning, my dear 11 students. Now I am going to start dimension analysis. What is the use of the dimension analysis, which is going to be used when we are doing calculations and so many things. We want to convert the unit from one system to another system. With the help of the dimension analysis, we are going to convert units from one system to another system. Dimension analysis, which is otherwise called factor label method, which is otherwise called unit label method. There are three names: dimensional analysis, factor label method, and third one is unit label method. Right, children? Now let me proceed the first question. In your page number, children, 243, they have given very clear table from one factor to another factor how it is going to be converted. Everything is given. They have given very big table. Can go through page number 243. Right, children? Now, okay. Let us give first example, children. Take down the example. A piece of metal. A piece of metal, 3 inches. A piece of metal. Metal, 3 inches. 3 inches in long. In long. What is it is? It's in. What is it? Its length in centimeter. Yes, children. This is the first question. A piece of metal 3 inches is 3 inches in long. What is its length in centimeter? First, you should know the relation between centimeter and inches. So let me write what is 1 inch. 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeter. 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeters. This relation between centimeter and inches. Okay, now which way I am going to carry out this sum? Listen carefully. So I am going to convert 3 inch into centimeter, children. Right? Inch. So 3 inches. 3 inches equal to 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeter. How can I write? So 1 inch is equal to, children, 1 inch. 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeter, right? Otherwise, it is equal to 2.54 centimeter divided by 1 inch. I can write in either way. Both are same. 1 inch, 2.54 centimeter. I can write in this way also, or in this way also. Both are equal. Right. Now what I am going to do, I am going to convert from inches into centimeter. So 1 inch is equal to 2.54 centimeters, so 3 inches equal to, so what should be in the numerator, children? Centimeter should be in the numerator and inches should be the denominator, then only both will be cancelled. Right, children? So 2.54 centimeter, which is nothing but 1 inch. Right. So 1 inch get cancelled, we will get the answer 3 into 2.54 centimeter. Now my answer is in the centimeter. I want to convert inch into centimeter, children. Is it clear? So, namakku endha factor venumo, that should be in the numerator, right? What are the factors should be cancelled? That should be in the denominator. My aim is, I want to convert inch into centimeter. So, I just put the centimeter in the numerator and inches should be in the denominator, right? That inches get cancelled. My answer now. What is the answer, children? 7.62 centimeter. Answer is 7.62 centimeter. Now I have converted my unit from inches to centimeter. Is it clear? 7.62 centimeter. It's the first sum. Second sum, just take down, children. The first sum. So that clear to you? We are just converting one factor to another factor. Now let me move on to the second sum, children. Second sum, just take up second sum. A jug contains 2 liter milk. A jug contains 2 liter milk. 2 liter milk. Calculate the volume of the milk. Calculate the volume of the milk. Volume of the milk in meter cube. In meter cube. So clear, children? Yes. Just take down the sum. We know very well what we want to convert children. Liter into meter cube. Now our conversion unit conversion from liter into meter cube I want to convert. Okay children, now what I'm going to children, 1 liter is equal to 1000 centimeter cube. Right. 1 liter is equal to 1000 centimeter cube. 1 meter is equal to 10 to the power of, what is the meaning? 1 meter 100 centimeter. 100 centimeter. 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. Right. Now, answer is, we want to convert it into cube, centimeter cube. For this, what I am going to do? I am going to now convert. I am taking cube rule. 1 meter cube is equal to 100 cube into centimeter cube. Right. Yes. Now, shall I have this some children? Yes. Now, look at the sum. Now, how many liter? Liter to meter cube. Right? Liter to meter cube, just I am going to convert children. So, 2 liter. Now, 1 liter. 1 liter is equal to how many centimeter cube children? 1000 centimeter cube. Right. My answer should come in meter cube. So that meter cube should be in the numerator. So what will be the denominator? Centimeter cube. Right. Is that clear children? So liter get cancelled. Centimeter cube get cancelled. So what is the answer children now? 2 into 10 to the power 3. Here 100 cube. What is the meaning 100 cube children? It is nothing but 10 to the power. Let me write it in the denominator. 10 to the power 6. Yes. Now 2 into 10 to the power. Meter cube. This is the answer. 2 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter cube. Yes children, now liter into meter cube. Okay, now my conversion is liter to meter cube children. Here 1 liter we know the conversion factor. 1 liter is equal to 1000 centimeter cube. Right. Now what is the relationship between centimeter and meter children? 1 meter is equal to 1000 centimeter. Now my answer must be meter cube. So what I am going to do is, I am going to take a cube root on both sides. So 1 meter cube is equal to 100, you want to take cube root as well as centimeter cube. I am going to substitute these values in this case. Right. Now 2 liter, that must be converted into meter cube. Right. 2 liter into 1 liter, what is the relation? 1000 centimeter cube. Liter meter get cancelled. Now what is the relationship between meter cube and centimeter cube? So 1 meter cube divided by 100 centimeter cube. Right, everything must be cancelled. What answer is finally you are going to get here children? 2 into 10 to the power minus 3 meter cube. Is it clear to you? Okay, now let me move on to the third sum, that is 2 days. Yes children, now we know very well we are going to relate between, we are going to convert from days to seconds. We are going to convert from days to seconds. So what I am going to do is, so 1 day is equal to 24 hours, right? So 1 hour is equal to 60 minutes. 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. So I'm going to move from days to seconds. So these many conversion factors I'm going to use now. Okay. Now let us use one by one children. Now how many days you want to convert? So 2 days. Right. 2 days. So one day must be cancelled. That should be in the denominator, right? 1 day, 24 hours, right? Then day must be cancelled. So 1 lakh 60 seconds, 60 minutes. Sorry, 60 minutes. Yes, 1 lakh 60 minutes, right? 1 minute 60 seconds. So look at the board, children. 2 days. I'm going to convert it to seconds. Second should be in the numerator. Okay, 2 day, which means 1 day 24 hours. I'm going to cancel the hours, right? Then 1 hour, which contains 60 minutes. Again, what I want to do is minutes should be cancelled. So 1 minute is equal to 60 seconds. Okay, now we can cancel day, hour, minute, we will cancel. We'll write a numerical, children. 2 into 24 into 60 into 60. Right, 60 seconds. So what is the answer? Final answer is 1728 00 seconds. This is my answer. Is it clear to you, children? So in this way, we are going to convert from one unit to another unit. So clear? There are 3 sums I have given to you. I will give the remaining sums in the video, children. Thank you for watching. Thank you so much.